Well, Asha Rangappa is a CNN legal and national security analyst and a senior lecturer at Yale University, as well as a former special agent with the FBI. And she joins me now live from Hamden, Connecticut. Good to have you with us.
Thank you.
Is Flynn the key to Mueller's investigation? And given the plea deal, does this suggest that Mueller is trying to catch a much bigger fish?
Yes. So when prosecutors make deals with defendants, particularly defendants where they have a lot of leverage, they're not going to give up that leverage unless that person has significant enough information to let them go higher up the chain. In Mike Flynn's case, he had a lot of potential crimes that he could have been charged with. And those include failing to register as a foreign agent. There were reports that he had been trying to plot to kidnap a Turkish opposition leader and deliver that person to Turkey. Those crimes could have landed him in jail for 30 years or more. And instead, his plea deal recommends a sentence of 0 to 6 months. That means that Mueller believes that as a senior member of this campaign, he saw and he heard things from the most senior people in this administration that are going to help him build his case that he needs to make.
Now, President Trump insists that he is not worried. Let's just take a quick listen to what he had to say yesterday.
What has been shown is no collusion, no collusion. There's been absolutely no collusion, so we're very happy.
So just to be clear, presidential transition teams can talk to foreign governments to make introductions, but they can't discuss policy. Is that where this becomes a major legal problem?
Well, it's not even about the policy issue. Transition teams can talk to foreign governments, and they can even discuss policy. The issue is that this needs to be carefully coordinated with the sitting administration. At any given time, the United States has one president, and that president speaks with one voice with the outside world. So it's important that everyone remain on the same page, and if there's going to be a policy shift, for that to be communicated so that the sitting administration can take measures accordingly and craft their policy. What was going on here, Linda, is that these communications that were apparently happening even in the transition period were being done covertly, and they were being done against the explicit request of the Obama administration with regard to the sanctions specifically. And this has the result of sending confusing messages, and one where the channels, the diplomatic channels that the U.S. is operating on, become very muddled.
And now court documents plus emails from a former Trump advisor obtained by the New York Times show that Flynn was not acting alone. Let's just take a quick look to what a Trump advisor wrote in an email. She said, if there is a tit-for-tat escalation, Trump will have difficulty improving relations with Russia, which has just thrown the U.S. election to him. Now, the White House initially claimed that Flynn had gone rogue in his dealings with the Russians. This seems to suggest otherwise.
That's right. What that email and, in fact, what the statement of facts that Flynn pleaded guilty to reveal is that there was actually a coordinated effort and to reach out to Russia, to be in communication with them, and that everyone was on the same page. And I want to also point out that this is not something that can be viewed in isolation. Even much earlier in the campaign, Another person who pleaded guilty with Mueller, George Papadopoulos, was in touch with Russians and also letting people know in the campaign about his contacts and setting up meetings, and they were all on board. So, again, it's not just this December transition meeting. These were similar to the patterns that were happening in the campaign.
All right, Asha Rangappa, good to get your perspective. Thanks so much. This story is certainly not going away. We will talk to you again very soon. Thank you.
Thank you.